Hello guys, good morning. Today our video is on part 2 for class 9 of types of software. In this module, we learn about the software application type. And as well, in this module, we also try to solve the question answers of this chapter. So let's move here the types of software part 2. Types of software, as we already discussed about system software, now in this part we are discussing about the application software. Application software means what? The careless necessary operations for a specified application to fulfill. That means when we want to do different of tasks, different of work with the help of computer, that time we use apps or application software. Application software has two partitions. First one is general purpose software, another one is specific purpose software. General purpose software like MS Office software. MS Office like Suite, word processor, presentation, spreadsheet, image editor, etc. While specific like reservation system, attendance system, billing system, report system, generator, etc. So here we are discussing the both part of general and specific purpose computer application software. So start with the general purpose application software. In this module, general purpose software is what? General purpose application software are mass produced with the intention that it will be used a wide variety of different users in a range of different situations. Microsoft Office, Adobe company, Photoshop, Adobe, other Google Chrome and Google Plus are the examples of these type of software. Now we are starting with Office package. It is also called PC package or PC suite. The very first application software of this PC suite is word processor. Word processor means what? Most of the work we do in the format of words or in the typing method or the sentence method. It requires a kind of software which is necessary to type or which necessary to get the information in the module of words. So here, word processing is a term used in the computer education for typing, editing, saving for the further future references, printing and kind of text, letters and articles, etc. So these kind of software are used to for what are called word processor. Examples are there: PageMaker, Microsoft Word, OpenOffice Writer. So these are the software which are very useful for the typing purpose. Now the second one. The second is presentation tool. What is presentation means? Presentation, when we want to represent anything, like I want to represent something here as a presentation, I use different of apps in the cell. Presentation tools is a software package that facilitates the creation of presentations on any particular topic. Some of the examples are given. A presentation is a combination of slides, handouts, notes and outline, all kind in a single file or single group of people. The examples are MS PowerPoint and Impress, etc. That means presentation, MS PowerPoint presentation we already done in class 9 earlier as well as in class 8 also. Now the third one is spreadsheet tool. Spreadsheet, sheet, a kind of calculation work is used spreadsheet format. A spreadsheet is a computer application that is help in organizing and analysis of information in tabular form. It is primarily used to work with statistical data and can also help in organizing information to calculate and do the formulas also. For an example, some tools are Microsoft Excel and OpenOffice Calc. With the help of this, we create different of sheet for calculation purpose. Here we use MS Excel mostly, where we do different of calculation, use different of formulas and other things, and maintain these in a group of workbook or worksheets. After this, we move to our next portion. Our next portion is database management system, which is also called DBMS. is a part of RDBMS. RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. What is the database management? For an example, many of students are there in a school. How we maintain the data of these students all together? It is all the happen because of DBMS. So database management system is a software package that enables you to store, modify, and extract information from a database. A database is a structured set of data held in computer, especially one of that accessible in various ways. Popular examples of database are MS Office, Base, MySQL, Oracle, SQL Server, and last one, Microsoft Access. With the help of these programs or software, we are able to complete all the work of database management. After this, these are our general purpose software. Now, we are moved to our specific purpose application software. Specific purpose application software means what? The software which are maintained or which are designed for the particular reason or for the particular purpose. We use this specific purpose application software, or as the name suggests, is more specific towards a particular organization or an individual. It is such a software which meets all the requirements of the organization of individual to whom it may be concerned. It is created for a specific task or purpose. It is used as known the environment. What it means? It means, for an example, I want to make a reservation for myself in a train. Then what kind of application I use? I simply use specific purpose, IRCTC. Or I want to maintain the account of my firm or my bank or my school or my any organization. Then what I use? I use Tally and different kind of these are called specific purpose computer application software. Now we are moving to further about the different of things. The very first one is accounting management software. Accounting management software, it is a practical application of management techniques to analyze, control and report onto financial health of the organization, thus requiring analyzing, planning, implementation of and the control of programs designed to provide financial data and reporting of that manager. Different examples are there like Tally, Busy, Mark and QuickBooks. These are the software to maintain the account handling work. After the completing accounting software, we move to our second one, reservation system. Reservation system or computerized reservation system is software that is used to store and retrieve information and conduct transaction related to railway, air travel, hotels, rental activities. So here we use different of reservation system. Like you want to board on a train, that time we use IRCTC to reserve our ticket with the help of IRCTC. Here are give the examples are given. Centralized rail activities. Reservation system was originally designed and operated by airlines and currently is extended extensively and duplicate reservations. So IRCTC, other reservation website, IGO, Bibo, and hotels, My Hotels, Trivago, likewise different of activities websites are there which are capable to make reservation for us. Now, after this, human resource management system. HR ministry is also a part of human resource management. Here we are talking about the human resource management system. For example, in your school, many of teachers are working there, but how they give their attendance, how they get their salary, how to maintain their attendance, absent present, how they get increment, how the students, how many days the students attend the school. These all the things are maintained by human resource management system, where attendance system is the most important one. It is our online attendance system is also applicable in different of the schools and universities. Likewise, after that, we are moved to our second part of application software, where we are talking about the mobile application, because 2020 is totally dependent on mobile. This time, every youngster use different of mobile things and mobile phones regularly in their daytime, 4 to 5 hours regularly for different of work like online education and other thing, as you also do the same in today's. So every day we use so many apps, applications on our mobile devices, various purpose. Some of our use that is called software application development, and devices such as smartphones and tablets, rather the desktop or laptop computer. Generally, we classify these apps into three different categories. So whenever we are talking about the mobile phones, there are three different categories are there when we use apps on it. There are the categories name are web apps, native apps, hybrid apps. So these three, these days we see the mobile devices mainly running on Android, iOS or Windows 10. Most of us we are use Android, Apple use iOS, and some of the Nokia's, Microsoft phone use Windows 10. These known operating system or platform native apps developed to target one specific platform like Android 10S or Windows. Hybrid apps are hybrid apps. Now, first one is the native web app or native app. Second one is hybrid app. Hybrid apps are developed to target multiple platforms. That means, for example, WhatsApp. WhatsApp is an hybrid apps which is used in Apple, Android as well as Windows phone. So multiple platforms, whereas webs are apps are mobile optimized web pages that look like an app. Some of the website provide the mobile view, and this mobile view is just a simple web page and which is used as app. After completing this work, the main thing is that we here are discussing about the question answer session once again. So first question is about tick the correct questions. Here are the question number one. I just simply write the answer, read the answers for you to get the answers. But again, I suggest you that find the answers by yourself and complete your work. So first one is answer is C, system software. Second is Microsoft Word. Third one is library programs. Fourth one is which among the following is not an antivirus software? The answer is WinZip. Fifth one is about utility software, and answer is B, Figmation utility. Our question number six, which among the following type of translator? As we very well know, interpreters is a translator. Okay, after that, which of the following is not an example of word processor? OpenOffice Calc is not a word processor, is a spreadsheet processor. That organizing, analyzes information, tabular form, spreadsheet. Now tabular form we are also known about spreadsheet. Next one is example of DBMS, OpenOffice Base is there. Which of the following is not a mobile application? System app is not a mobile application, as you all read now. After completing this, we move to the fill up area. The first question is, answer is software. Second one is antivirus. Third one is quarantine. Fourth one is utility. Fifth one is backup. Sixth one is library. Here, quarantine. This time we all are more in the way of our quarantine, which is good for our health. The same, because it is good for our system health. Next, move to question number seven. Seven, answer is language processor. Eighth one is presentation tool. Ninth one is encryption. Tenth one is a mobile app. These are the 10 questions of the fill-up, which we have the answers in blue color. After that, we are moved to true-false section. Now here, they'll give the answer in true or false manner. So question number one is true. Question number two is true. Three is true. Four, five, six, seven, all are true. This is a good one thing is that all answers are true. But I again suggest find out the question by yourself. Maybe the answer is not as you think so. Now the short answer question. What is a software? Answer is given. What is a database management system? Question number two. Question number three is state any one use of accounting management software. Question number four. What is human resource management? Question number five. What is the function of proximity reader in an attendance system? What is the attendance system? We very well known. So five very short questions are given and all answer also suggested here. Now we move to the short answer questions. Now, in this short answer question, what is the system software? Name the different type of system software. In the very first part, we are already discussed about the system software and its type. So this is asked the same question. So this is the question number one. This answer are given. Question number two, state any two functions of operating system. Operating systems give two functions. Very simple is there. So here are the two answers. Third one is, what is antivirus software? I also explain the term quarantine. Again, once again, the quarantine is there. So after question number three, we move to question number four. What are mobile applications, apps? We very well know. Nowadays, we use different of apps with our mobile phone. So now we move to the question number five. What is the use of compression utility software? Answer is given. I also suggest you to find out yourself, state at least two advantages of using backup utility software. So after question number six, we move to question number seven. Question number seven is, how does the process of defragmentation speed up the computer system? Defragmentation, I also told you about the disk defragmentation, which is very useful to make our data in good manner. Now the question number eight, what are library programs? Now next is, what is the significance of using language translator? These are the nine questions. Now move to the next proportion. Next one is state difference between. Answer is given. Question number 11, what is the presentation tool? Give two examples of presentation software. So is give the answer of the presentation tool. Question number 12, what is the use of statistical data? Question number 13, state two features of accounting management software. And 14, what is the reservation system? We already discussed about. 15, what is the function of payroll? And question number 16, name two devices used an automated attendance system. And 17, one is, what is the inventory control system? 18, state one difference between native apps and web apps. Now we move to the long answer. Question number one, what is the significance of using billing system? Question number two, describe the use of accounting management system. Question number three, what are the presentation tool used for? Question number four, explain the working of an interpreter and compiler. So after that, we move to the next question. These are the difference between 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 differences are given between of interpreter and compiler. Now, what is the function of encryption and decryption tool? Now, the next one is, what are hybrid apps? What are the hybrid apps? As we are even known, different of platform work together, that is called hybrid app. After this question, we move to next, and this is our end of the session. So I hope that you understand quite well. If you have any doubt, please comment on my YouTube channel. Thank you very much.